Carl, with the argument regarding single providers, nobody in Thurrock would demand that Coca-Cola stay in Atlanta and Atlanta only. So isn't that the same argument, what you're wanting with Thurrock businesses to come first?
No, you're comparing apples and oranges. Coca-Cola and all those multinational companies are a million miles away from what we're doing in Thurrock. What we want is the council taxpayers' money to be spent with local companies and protect local jobs. I mean, it's a crazy idea that you can even consider exporting £6 million worth of business every year to companies that have no link and no affiliation to Thurrock. The 18 or so contractors that work for Thurrock actually employ local people. That money is spent in the local economy and it keeps local business going during the hard times as well as the good times. And we're not looking for a sweetheart deal. We're not looking for special favours. We're looking for them to honour their agreements with local businesses. And I think that's the correct way of moving forward. And it's what local councils are all about, looking after their local people.
But can you understand and appreciate the legal advice that the Cabinet had been given in respect of possibly European directives and European law?
Well, European law is one thing, but I think the Federation of Small Businesses have made it perfectly clear that councils up and down the country tend to chunk up or chunk down their contracts to fit their local circumstances, and no European law is going to stop you doing that. I think what the council have done is has got some legal advice from the legal team to fit what they want to do. The council voted to scrap the idea of a single contract. The Tories are saying, we are the friend of business. Well, now it's time for them to prove it and scrap those single contract ideas and get into a real dialogue where council taxpayers get value for money for what local firms do and also get value for money for local businesses. Well, I want to see local businesses employing local people to thrive and survive during this economic recession.
So where within a council chamber are we going with this? You put a motion forward in council, mm-hmm. Which was couched in certain terms. Now Cabinet have had legal advice. What's the next stage within the council chamber?
Well, I think that the Cabinet ought to, instead of supinely and unquestioningly accept legal advice, they should really have said, well, is this correct? The council have suggested that we go down one route. We should do all we can to bow to the will of the council. This is not 10 people, this is 49 people in the council, and there was a cross-party majority for everything that was said and done on the 29th of January. And I'm just astonished that they're not carrying out the will of the council. It's a real issue about the supremacy of the full council. It's a bit like Parliament saying we're going to do one thing and then the Cabinet saying we're going to do something completely different.